Senator, like also to in addition to Attorney Rolex Suplico, i-explain ko sana po yung timeline sa nangyari ng SMNI. Yung NTC po nag-issue ng 30-day suspension last December 19, 2023. Ang basis ng NTC is only a mere resolution from the House of Representatives. Hindi ka tayo binigyan ng pagkakataon na magpaliwanag. It's just a mere resolution from the House of Representatives. So, ang ginagawa ng SMNI, nag-file po tayo ng certiorari petition sa Court of Appeals. But of course, the CA denied it on the ground that hindi daw kami nag-file ng MR sa NTC. So, ang ginagawa naman after that, so we did not file an MR to the Court of Appeals. After the 30-day suspension, ang ginagawa ng NTC, nag-issue naman sila ng indefinite suspension na wala namang hearing. So sabi nila that this suspension, preventive suspension daw. But when I say preventive suspension, at least my term, 60 days ba, 30 days ba, ngayon lang ako nakakita ng preventive suspension na indefinite. Hindi natin alam kung 30 days ba, 60 days ba, 1 year ba. So walang naka-indicate kung hanggang kailan ang indefinite suspension ng NTC. And wala din tayong, hindi tayo binigyan ng pagkakataon na magpaliwanag bakit may na-violate ang SMNI with respect sa rules ng NTC, sa Certificate of Public Convenience, or even the franchise. So after that, nag-file po tayo ng motion for reconsideration sa NTC noong February 2. But of course, without any hearing, still, the NTC denied our motion for reconsideration against the indefinite suspension ng SMNI. Yung last hearing po, nung pre-hearing, tama yung sinabi ni Attorney Suplico, walang lawyer na pumunta sa NTC, walang representative from the NTC, sa walang pre-trial brief kasi under the rules, kasi supplementary kasi yung rules of court ng rules ng NTC. And based yan sa NTC rules. Ibig sabihin ng supplementary po, kung wala yung under the rules ng NTC, kung hindi, kung wala doon, gagamitin po natin ang rules ng court. Nakalagay doon sa rules of court na if you fail to file a pre-trial brief, it has the same effect of failure to appear. If you fail to appear, it means the case should be dismissed in with prejudice. But of course, sabi ng hearing officer doon na we will put that in writing. So last kahapon, nag-file po kami ng motion to dismiss sa NTC. Hopefully, they will respond it on our favor pursuant to the provision ng ating salikang batas. Yes po, may mga grounds po ang NTC or even the Congress ano daw yung mga violation natin. May sabi nila, fake news, mga false information. Ang sabi ko naman, may provision po tayo sa ating salikang batas na about the protection of freedom of press and freedom of expression. And may jurisprudence po ng Supreme Court na mere inaccuracy of reporting is still covered by the freedom of press and freedom of expression. In fact, may jurisprudence that freedom of press and freedom of expression is one of the highly protected constitutional right. In fact, in the Supreme Court case of Chavez versus Gonzalez and NTC, nakalagay po doon, any government agencies na gumagawa ng order na might affect freedom of press and freedom of expression are presumed unconstitutional. That's why the stand of SMNI, lahat po ng order ng NTC are presumed unconstitutional pursuant to Chavez versus Gonzalez and NTC. Then, hindi yan nasagot ng SMNI. Ng NTC. Second, they also base it about na binenta daw ng SMNI ang shares of stocks ng Suarsug Media Corporation. Ang sagot po dyan, hindi po. Nag-start po ang SMNI ng 50 million ang capitalization hanggang umabot po ng 650 million. And wala pong pagbebenta ng controlling interest kasi nakalagay po sa sa pangkisa ng batas ng SMNI na pwede, kailangan i-report sa Congress ang pagbebenta if ang ibenta is controlling interest. In this case, walang controlling interest kasi the Kingdom of Jesus Christ na-maintain po nila ang 53.5% or more than the controlling interest at yung binenta or transfer po through donation or through additional capitalization is only 46% and that is less than 50.1% na kailangan i-report sa Congress. And second po, sabi nila, yung dispersal po ng ownership about the 30%. We are on the ng SMNI or the Suarsug Media Corporation, we are on the process of transmitting or dispersing the ownership of 30%. In fact, may 1% na mahigit ang nalipat na from the share of Pastor Kiboloy to the cooperative. So it means we are on the process. In fact po, kung tingnan niyo po ang Republic Act 10818, yung Radio Mindanao, iba yun sa SMNI kasi ang sa Radio Mindanao, within 5 years, dapat may dispersal of ownership within 5 years. But yung batas ng SMNI or Suarsug, wala nakalagay po na 5 years. Anytime, i-disperse po ang 30%. So walang term limit kung kailan po ang 5 years. So i-compare mo sa ibang mga prangkisa like the Radio Mindanao, kailangan within 5 years from the operation, kailangan may dispersal of ownership ng 30% sa public. Walang nakalagay po dyan sa prangkisa ng SMNI. So therefore, we are still within the time frame to transmit or the disperse about the 30%. And second, kailangan natin i-emphasize po na about the franchise ng SMNI that still part, yes, subject to public interest. So therefore, i-grant yan ng Congress. But if it is already granted, it is considered a property right. So kasi property right na po yan, kailangan i-comply po ang due process clause ng ating saligang batas. Kasi very number one po yan sa Bill of Rights. No person shall be deprived of life, liberty, or property without due process of law. And nor shall be deprived of the equal protection of the law. It means, Mr. Chairman or Mr. Senator, wala, hindi po tayo binigyan ng pagkakataon na magpaliwanag. That's why we are very thankful in this committee na at least explain po natin one by one ano po yung stand ng SMNI na hindi po namin na-experience sa House of Representatives or events sa NTC. Kasi nakatanggap lang kami ng mga order ng NTC December 9, January 18, March 18, na hindi kami binigyan ng pagkakataon na magpaliwanag. And we believe na lahat po ng order ng NTC pursuant sa decision ng Supreme Court in Chavez versus Gonzales and NTC are presumed unconstitutional. So therefore, the burden of proof na mag-establish that those resolutions are constitutional ang NTC, hindi po ang SMNI or Suarsug because freedom of press and freedom of expression is the highest protected constitutional right guaranteed by the Philippine Constitution as part of a democratic and republican government. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Maraming salamat po, Attorney Tolentino. Meron po pa kayong gustong idagdag, Kajay?
Wala na po, balibala
ko may mga itatanong. Apo, babalik po tayo sa tanungan. Pakinggan naman po natin ang NTC. Sino po ang Attorney Ella Blanca B. Lopez, Commissioner ng NTC. Ma'am, magandang umaga po.
Magandang umaga po, Chairperson Senator Robin Hood Padilla, sa members po ng Committee on Public Information and Mass Media, fellow government workers, members po ng industry. Good morning po sa ating lahat. We are very appreciative po of the opportunity that even if the NTC is not actually po an expert on content or content press freedom because we don't regulate content. But we are given an opportunity now to to express our humble views and opinion on press freedom and its consequences. And kami po ay nagpapasalamat din po sa nabanggit niyo po kanina, Mr. Chairperson, that in this forum, hindi po tayo mag-away-away, there may be questions that we may not be able to answer at this time because po pending po sa aming sa NTC po ang kaso, at meron din pong nakabinbin na kaso sa Supreme Court on a similar matter. Then moving forward, meron po akong konting prepared opinion po for the NT from the NTC. So again, the NTC holds in high regard and is and has been upholding the constitutional guaranteed rights of press freedom. The freedom of the press, as already mentioned, is enshrined in the Constitution, which provides that no law shall be passed abridging the freedom of speech, of expression, or of the press, or of the right of the people peaceably to assemble and petition the government for redress of grievances. In the case of Gonzales versus Comelec, it was discussed that free speech and free press may be identified with the liberty to discuss publicly and truthfully any matter of public interest without censorship and punishment. It must be noted that the freedom of the press is important as it is the chief source of information on current affairs. It is the most pervasive and perhaps most powerful vehicle of opinion on public questions. It is the instrument by which citizens keep their government informed of their needs, their aspirations, and their grievances. It is the sharpest weapon in the key to fight government responsible and efficient. Without a vigilant press, the mistakes of every administration would go uncorrected and its abuses unexposed. Based on our readings, we note that the trend is to recognize the broadest scope and assure the widest latitude for this constitutional guarantee. In Chavez versus Gonzales, it was held that the freedom of the press should not be confined to ideas that are conventional or capable or acceptable to the majority. Thank you. And instead, should allow and even encourage the articulation of the unorthodox view, though it be hostile or derided by others, or though such view induces or conditions or a condition of unrest, creates dissatisfaction with conditions as they are, or even steers people anger. It must be noted that freedom of the press, that the freedom protects speech, print, and assembly regarding secular as well as political causes, and is not confined to any particular field of human interest. The protection covers myriad matters of public interest or concern, embracing all issues about which information is needed or appropriate. Jurisprudence also held that freedom of expression is not an absolute nor is an unbridled license that gives immunity for every possible use of language and prevents the punishment of those who abuse this freedom. Thus, all speech are not treated the same. Some types of speech may be subjected to some regulation by the state under its pervasive police power in order that it may not be injurious to the equal rights of others or those of the community or society. To end my message, Mr. Chairperson, I'd like to quote an article I found in the Philippine Star by Ms. Pia Roses Morato entitled Freedom of Speech and Its Limitation, published in September 23, 2023. And I quote, "While we all live in a free and democratic Philippines, the freedom of speech also has its limits, especially when harmful content can lead to hate speech and false statements against people. The president himself has said that Filipinos suffer from misinformation and disinformation, and as a matter of principle, fake news should not have a place in modern society. Yet, as a free press functions as a watchdog and is an integral part of freedom of speech, defamation and inciting to hatred and discrimination is impermissible. Hence, in both principle and practice, some limitations are always exercised. Freedom of the press provides the people a platform for a great number of voices to be heard, but despite that, the fake content industry, which has produced serious effects on press freedom, is turned weakened journalism. where massive disinformation jeopardizes the right to truthful information. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairperson. Good morning po sa ating lahat.
Maraming salamat po, Attorney Ella Blanca P. Lopez, ating pong commissioner. Meron pong gusto magdagdag sa NTC? Okay na po? Okay. Maraming salamat po. Dito naman po tayo kay Attorney Rudolph Steve E. Jularbar, atin pong spokesperson. Ng kapisanan ng mga broadcaster ng Pilipinas. Sir, magandang tanghali po. Sir Attorney, sandali lang po, boss, ha? Ano lang, parang wala po kayong speaker yata. Hindi natin siya marinig. Yan na po, sir. Opo, thank you.
An action to revoke the franchise of a broadcast company. By the way, Mr. Chairperson, it is important to note that the Philippines is probably the only country where a legislative franchise is required for broadcast media. I have tried to research all other jurisdictions, and it appears that it is only the Philippines. This is probably because we hazard to opine that this is probably because broadcast media is considered a public utility in the Philippines. But it has now been classified as a public service with the passage of the Public Service Act. And so probably Congress might want to revisit the power to grant legislative franchise. As stated by the prior speakers, the freedom of expression of the press and media are so important. They are cornerstones of democracy. And even in the legislative franchise, these are protected rights. It is important to note that even the legislative franchise issued by Congress requires that no prior restraint should be exercised or no censorship should be exercised in the broadcast. And it is only required that the broadcast is cut off after the fact. Also, it is the position of KBP that political speech should be granted the highest respect. There are different kinds of expression, political expression, commercial expression, expression of the art, but political speech has been always considered the highest form of freedom of expression. And so the KBP is of the position that if the reason for canceling the broadcast is because of political speech, which probably might have offended some parties, this should not be a valid ground for the cancellation of a legislative franchise. By the way, Honorable Chairperson, ganun ang position ng KBP, lalo na sa political speech, eh walang fake news. Yung tinatawag na fake news ngayon, dati na propaganda ang tawag doon. Disinformation, misinformation is part and parcel of political speech and should be protected. Because otherwise, if dissent is not allowed, what is the purpose of the protection of the freedom of expression? This was enunciated in the case of Chavez versus Comelec, when they said that the highest protection should be given to dissent, to those that don't conform, those that bring different ideas. This should be the protected expressions. And so, Honorable Chairperson, the KPP is thankful that it has the opportunity to express one of its mission, that is the protection of freedom of expression and of the press. Thank you, Mr. Chairperson.
Maraming salamat po, Attorney. Napakalinaw po ng inyong pagpapaliwanag. Maraming salamat po. Ma'am Ms. Lydia Bueno, ang presidente po ng National Press Club. Ma'am? Mga mahal naming bisita, mag-ano lang po kami ng 2-minute break para lang po pag-ayos lang ng audio. Maraming salamat po. Enjoy nyo lang po nyo muna yung pagkain.
Check, check, sound. Check, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Check, check, sound. Check, 1, 2. Sound, check, hello.
Thank you for the opportunity to air our views from the National. Exercise of press freedom in the country in its more than 7 decades of existence po. Nasa 72 years na po ang National Press Club. It has managed to resist the storms in all sorts of trials and threats to press freedom. To this day, the National Press Club stands as one of the symbols of the country's free and working democracy. With the proliferation of the content creators or the so-called bloggers or bloggers in various social media platforms, the National Press Club imposed stricter policy in the acceptance of its members. These bloggers and vloggers can become members of the NPC only if they belong or part of legitimate online media websites. So these bloggers and vloggers have given a new meaning to the press freedom and the practice of journalism in the country. They make the public believe that they are part of the mainstream media by creating and delivering their messages to the public through various media platforms without the benefit of being subjected to rigorous editing and or editorial control. In short, they were not accountable to anyone, not even to themselves. Most of them were encouraged to post because online platforms were paying them good money, which traditional media owners could not match. The most unfortunate part is that they could post everything and anything under the sun, which often result in confusion and misinformation among the public. Indeed, these so-called content creators have been redefining the rules and boundaries of journalism and the meaning of press freedom, with many of them not trained on traditional mode of reporting. They could not care less about journalism code of ethics. So it is therefore the responsibility at the National Press Club to keep that flame of truth, accuracy, justice, and fairness that define true journalism and press freedom alive and burning. There's nothing wrong with being a content creator or social media practitioner. However, it is our duty to impart to them that they have responsibilities and duties that must be observed. Those who enter the media industry must adhere to the codes of journalists live by, such as accuracy, truthfulness, and fairness. So as to the consequences, aware and knowledgeable of the freedom of expression and of the press that has been freely exercised in the country, experienced mainstream media avoid going beyond the boundaries and limitations in the profession. They know for a fact that doing this will result to cases relating to ordinary libel. We also have these cyber libel laws, the violation of the violence against women and children, the anti-terrorism law, and the national security law, among others. NPC members are kept informed of their duties and responsibilities in the exercise of their profession and warned the possibilities of facing such charges if found to be abusive of the freedom given to them by the Constitution. The 1987 Constitution, especially the Bill of Rights, Article 3, Section 4, states that no law shall be passed abridging the freedom of speech, of expression, and of the press, or the right of the people peaceably to assemble and petition the government for redress of grievances. So our recommendations are, there must be a specific law enforcing stricter penalties for bloggers and vloggers who abused their freedom under the Constitution, or the existing laws providing limitations to press freedom be amended or strengthened to contain abuses of press freedom. That's all, Senator Padilla.
Maraming salamat po, Ms. Lydia Bueno. ng National Press Club. Mamaya po, may mga tanong din po kami.
Yes, po.
Apo. Susunod naman po natin na si Attorney Anthony A. Abad. Prof, kanina po, pinag-uusapan pa rin namin kung gaano kahalaga ang freedom of the press, freedom of religion, freedom of expression, freedom of speech. Ito po bang mga kalayaan na ito ay kapag napangalagaan, ito po ba ay nakatutulong sa ekonomiya? At kung ito naman po ba ay iyong sinakal, ito po ba ay nakakaapektong negatibo sa ekonomiya?
Okay. Una-una, marami pong salamat, Mr. Chairman. I'm happy that you invited me again to your hearing. I was a little puzzled na dito ako sa press freedom. And I'm to clarify, I'm not representing anybody related to the SMNI case. I'm here purely as an academic. I do not also represent Ateneo de Manila, my home university. These are my own personal opinions. But I'm also, I'm also a former broadcast person. I used to be with Bloomberg Philippines, no, until they terminated the license. No, I used to be a host of a program. So I'm also conscious or aware of the importance of the freedom space that should be given to journalism and media. No? Ngayon, ang tanong nyo po, yung mga freedoms guaranteed under the Constitution, under the Bill of Rights, no? How important are they? And dahil economics professor rin ako, I have to make this link, no? Na nakaano rin dyan sa economic development. No? So, una-una, what is a constitution for? Yung going back to the basics. Constitution, una-una, ay nagtatayo ng isang pamahalaan that is supposed to be set up by the people. Kaya by the people and for the people. But there is also, in the evolution of constitutions, the portion of the constitution which guarantees certain basic rights to the citizens of that society that puts up that constitution in order to make everyone work well together. So it creates a zone of peace and stability. That way, if we go to the basic right of individual liberty or the theory of individual liberty, everyone is guaranteed the right to behave and do what they want. May freedom of individual creativity, freedom of profession, freedom of labor, etc. You should be able to do what you want. Ang caveat dun is that you can do what you want, but do no harm to others. So, the Constitution is supposed to guarantee that there is that working relationship or that harmonious relationship in society. That's why you have all of these basic rights. The moment mawala yung isang right, isang freedom of, say, yung separation of church and state, yung freedom of the press, no? Then it makes the citizen insecure. Kailangan secure ang ang mamamayan, eh. That every day you can do your, you can go by and do your whatever it is you do, no? Na wala kang takot. You should be able to live in that manner. So that's why tayo po, Senator, we want to review our constitution, because we want to make sure that the constitution is true to its mandate and its preamble to protect the people. Ngayon, on this topic, tong freedom of expression, yes, it's very important na magarantiya ang freedom of expression. In fact, it is the way that the citizens in a society can work best together if you are allowed to give your opinion without fear that you will be punished or that you will be suppressed for expressing your opinion. That's why the Constitution puts certain limits on both the state while imposing duties on the citizen. So, una-una, responsibility of the state or limits on the state power. Dahil galing tayo sa mga galing tayo sa mga absolute monarchy, dictatorships, where there was no such thing as freedom of expression. Only what the king or the emperor wanted is what would happen. But eventually we evolved into more democratic society, and democracy is based on this ability of to say what you want without fear of the state or the kingdom punishing you or suppressing you. And that's the basic, that basic premise is how you begin your harmonious relationship within society. And meron rin mga duties ang citizen, ang mamamayan. Or, well, including private corporations and mass media operators. In fact, for mass media, you have a high level of responsibility because you are sharing information through a technology-driven means, no? Dahil may technology ka, you have this high responsibility to make sure that the content of your broadcast, of your news, is truthful and accurate, no? And fair. So again, you also cannot use the content of your news against people, or there is a what they call the threshold, no? When your words or your content will cause harm to others. So itong balance na to, ito ang importante sa isang society, no? Katulad ng Pilipinas. And the constitution should guarantee this, no? That's why yung ano rin, yung religion, we should be able to convert from one religion to another, express our own beliefs without fear that other religions will come after us, or the state on behalf of another religion will come after us. So yan ang basta ang standard po natin is that we should always be able to go from one place to another within the Philippines and do what we want to do within the Philippines without fear. If we can do that without fear, we can express ourselves, we can know without fear. But at the same time, also not doing harm to others. No? If we can do all that, then you've achieved already what is most important in society. And pag wala yung security at peace, wala rin tayong economy. Kasi walang mag-i-invest dito. That's why first thing is we want to remove all of these restrictions to investment. Then you want to make sure that the Philippines is a place that is safe for anybody to invest in, anybody to work or to do what they want to do. That's the, Senator. So, well, if we go to our review our Supreme Court cases to look at these basic freedoms, always remember it's a matter of balancing between the state responsibility to take care of the people, but at the same time to prevent abuse. At also to guarantee na may responsibility ang mga mamamayan to each other. So rule of law is very important. If you do anything harmful to another Filipino, you should be punished for it also. But in, well, for this case, I have no, since I'm not privy to this case, I cannot also comment on it properly. All I can say is that in both the for the state and for the mass media operator, always guarantee due process. And then we have standards of due process already in our jurisprudence, no? So pwede rin nating pag-aralan yan in doing that. So what's important is it's always open. There's a, you are given the right to listen. Ang problema ngayon is due to technological advancement, as was pointed out, ma'am, na it's very easy for people to put out their thoughts and opinions now. Very easy, dahil sa social media. You don't want to impose on social media. The state should not be intervening in social media in a way that it prevents people from expressing themselves. But at the same time, may responsibility rin eh. Yung problema nga yung katotohanan. What is true? Diba lahat tayo naman guilty sa Instagram of not being exactly truthful, no? We always put out our best photos, diba? Our best, ano? So, in a way, parang may, you know, what we see in social media is always people's best foot forward. So, we have to be cognizant of that. And when we craft our laws, our new laws and regulations for freedom of expression, for mass media, for everything, no? Literature, advertising, lahat yan may, ano, may creativity, content, may expression. And there's always a danger that there's falsehoods or maybe something harmful that will be put in that content. So we have to be very careful. I think it is important that we do review content, but also at the same time, we have to be careful about how we review. Kasi hindi tayo, gusto natin, we don't want to go back to the days of, let's say, sa U.S. colonial government. Ang problema sa constitution natin, actually, it's evolved from the U.S. colonial structure. And remember, U.S. colonial government, it's not the same as the U.S. government. It had to make sure that there was no dissent and that there was no opposition coming from the Filipinos at that time. No? So you have to also review your constitution and make sure that there are no more vestiges of that panahon na yun, yung colonial na ano na sistema. But anyway, we can discuss that siguro sa ano natin mga review ng constitution. But that's my take for now on the freedoms of press, etc. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Maraming salamat po, Prof. Ngayon naman po si Sir, sorry po ah. Attorney Eduardo M. Binuya Jr. po ng Department of Justice. Sir.
Thank you Mr. Chair. Very brief lang, Mr. Chair. As already mentioned by the other distinguished resource persons earlier, freedom of press freedom is a very important component of a democratic society. In fact, this is constitutionally guaranteed under Article 4, Article 3, Section 4 of the Constitution, as already cited several times earlier. In relation to this, ang DOJ po kasi as the principal law agency of the government, isa po sa mga mandates namin is to provide comments and legal opinions on certain legal issues, including proposed legislative measures or bills upon request of other government agencies. And so if in the event that there is a proposed bill that is transmitted to us for comments, we will be ready to provide comments and opinions. Yun lang, Your Honor, and we siguro in principle, if there is a bill. Proposed bill that will be filed.
Hindi po tayo nag-aaway-aaway dito. Consultative lang po ito. Ang gusto po natin, maliwanagan ng taong bayan kung ano po itong ganap na ito. Malinaw na po ngayon kung ano ang definition ng press freedom sa bawat isa. Ngayon lang po ay, ang gusto ko pong itanong, ito po ay sa DOJ. Ang pag-ere po ba ng religious shows at panonood nito, masasabi po ba natin na ito ay kabilang sa pag-practice ng religion? Yung po bang sa SMNI po kasi meron silang mga religious shows. Yung po ba sa ating pong pananaw, yun po ay yung mga taong nanonood po nito. Kanila pong ginagawa, pinapractice ang freedom of religion pagka nanonood po sila sa SM9 na mga religious shows.
Initially, Mr. Chair, sa tingin ko, yes. Yes. It is one of the modes of practicing one's religion, which is also constitutionally guaranteed. So, wala ako nakikitang hindi tama doon, Your Honor.
Salamat po. Tanungin po natin isang maiksipong paliwanag sa academe, Attorney Abad. Sir, pagka ganun po ba, Attorney? Ako po, halimbawa po ako, miyembro po ako ng Kingdom. Nanonood po ako sa SMNI. Hindi naman po ako, halimbawa, ako eh religious. Wala naman akong komento sa mga politiko o sa anuman nangyayari. Ang gusto ko lang mapanood sa SMNI, yung lang pag-preach ng religion nila. Yun po ba ay pagpa-practice ko ng freedom of religion pag nanonood ako? Hindi ko po pinanonood yung ano, ha? Hindi ko pinanonood yung mga public affairs. Pupunta lang ako sa SMNI para manood lang ako ng preaching, o, ng singing, gano'n. Yun po ba ay pagpa-practice ng freedom of religion?
Opo. Dahil kahit sa Roman Catholic, di ba, meron rin mga misa online. So, nandun din yung mga homily, so mga sermon ng mga pare, naririnig rin ng mga Catholics. So, gano'n din. It's their expression of religion, and dahil sa COVID, ngayon, it's their way of attending dahil ano na yan, considered attendance of mass, eh, yung ano, yung pagpanood ng mga misa.
Salamat po. Linawin lang po natin ano, kasi kailangan maintindihan po natin lahat ano. Ang Bible, ang tawag diyan, di ba, ay magandang balita. So, balita ito. Ibig sabihin, eh, considered po siya as pagpapahayag. So, ibig niyo pong sabihin, ito po, tanong ko po ito sa mga abogado ko, ha? So, ibig pong sabihin, pag ikaw ay nagpapahayag, maging ito man ay political o religion, ito po ba ay press freedom pa rin? Kayo po ang tinatanong ko. Ha? Ito po ba ay masasabi nating press freedom pa rin? Kasi siyempre po, ano, ako ay naghahayag ng magandang balita galing sa Panginoon Diyos. Di ba po, parang press din yan? Ano po ang, Sir Jay?
Mabuti na banggit po ninyo yan, Ginoong Chairman, ano. Kasi, kailan po sa publiko, ang Swaraso, ang SMNI, ay dalawa po. Kaya nga pag naririnig nyo yung aming slogan, para sa Diyos at sa Pilipinas nating mahal. Ang ibig sabihin nyo, kami, binabalansin namin kasi ang may-ari ng Swaraso ay yung Kingdom of Jesus Christ na black timer din po namin sa SMNI. Kaya meron kaming commercial component, meron din kaming sectoral component. At yun yung sinasabi nyo. Ngayon, kung ang tanong eh, ito ba ay pag-ahayag? Bahagi ba ito ng malayang pamamahayag? No? Or freedom of expression? Ako, sa ganang akin, sa karanasan ko, ito po ay kung titingnan ho natin sa spiritual na pananaw, mas mataas ho ito kaysa konstitusyon. Kasi, Panginoon ang ating pinag-uusapan dito. In other words, for me, that's why even when I was with ABS-CBN, we make it a point that we balance, no, our programming, that one day, a few hours in a week, we dedicate it to spiritual development. Whether it is the celebration of the Holy Mass for the Roman Catholic believers, the Bible study for Protestant churches, or for the expansion or explanation all the teachings of Prophet Muhammad in the case of the Islam way of life. So, yan ho para sa akin ay isang mahalagang bahagi ng malayang pamamahayag, Mr. Chairman.
Maraming salamat po. So, nag-a-agree po ba tayo na ang public affairs ng SMNI at ang religious programs ng SMNI ay magkahiwalay po ito?
Opo, katunayan, kanina nabanggit ni Attorney Olaybar, noong pinapanday namin at binabalangkas namin yung aming code, kasi mabanggit ko lang ho, noong 1970s, martial law, may mga sagka sa malayang pamamahayag dahil umiiral sa ang batas militar. Nanindigan po si Nakaduroy Valencia at si Mr. Antonio Barreiro, at nakiusap sila kay Pangulong Marcos noon na huwag niyong sagkain ang laya. Kami nang bahala riyan. That's why tinayo po yung KBP. Ito po yung samahan ng mga may-ari ng Himpilan at yung Broadcast Media Council, na sinasabi nila, sinasabi namin, responsable kami mga tao. Hindi nyo kinakailangan sagkain sapagkat kami kaya namin sumunod sa mga alituntunin ng Estado. So, kaya po nagkaroon ng laya, pumayag siya. As a matter of fact, kasi noon, medyo nababahala kami dahil pag sinabi ng NTC na yung permit to operate niyo, wala na, martial law eh. Pero dahil nga po, siguro si Yumaong Marcos ay naintindihan niya na sa malayang lipunan kailangan ng malayang pamamahayag, eh pumayag po siya sa self-regulation, which is now being practiced by KBP through their standards authority at sa mga individual network ombudsman through their own code of their own self-regulation. Limbawa sa ABS-CBN meron silang internal ombudsman, sa GMA meron din yung mga ganon, sa TV5. So kasi o pagka sinasagka, mahirap po. Kaya kami natutuwa na nagpatawag kayo ng ganitong talamitan, paliwanagan. Para nang sa ganon, matingnan natin ang daming pwedeng ibalangkasin panukalang batas. Para masusugan at mapaganda pa lalo. Kasi binanggit mo kanina, ano bang epekto nito sa ekonomiya? Alam nyo, katulad po ni Atty. Abad, ako rin po ay tuturo ng economics. Number one fundamental po is stability. Pagka hindi stable ang estado, nakikita nyo, biglang bumabagsak yung mga stock exchange, yung mga stocks. Kasi number one po yan eh, sa economic fundamentals. And stability sa isang demokrasya, katulad sa Pilipinas, kinakailangan, no, stable and ano, hindi, walang alinlangan, walang agam-agam ang mamumuhunan, the investors. Kaya importante po yung stability.
Maraming salamat po. Sa tanong ko po sa SMNI, sa grupo po ninyo, sa palagay po ba nyo nalabag ang karapatan ng mga membro ng kingdom sa pagkakabigay ng indefinite suspension sa SMNI? Ang kanila pong religious rights?
Yes po, na aside sa na-violate po ang freedom of press and freedom of expression, yes po, na-violate din po ang religious freedom ng mga members ng Kingdom of Jesus Christ. Kasi they practice their religion, yung faith nila sa Panginoong Diyos, sa panonood ng mga programs ng SMNI, lalo na yung mga religious programs. Yes po, sabi pa ng NTC na may mga limitation po ang freedom of press and freedom of expression. Yes, totoo po yan, there is no such thing as absolute freedom of press, or even religious freedom, walang tinatawag na absolute. But, for example, may certain violations ng allegedly yung sinasabi ni Ka Eric na nagtatanong lang siya about the 1.8 billion. May mga kaso naman na pwede isang pa. Pwede sila file ang kaso na libel. Pwede sila mag-file ang kaso na damages or act of terrorism, kung anong gusto nilang kaso. But not to affect the entire franchise of SM&I kasi nga pag naepektuhan yung prangkisa ng SM&I may chilling effect yan sa lahat po ng mga media. Why? Because freedom of press and freedom of expression is a constitutionally guaranteed right. Kasama doon po ang religious freedom ng bawat tao, lalo na yung mga members ng Kingdom of Jesus Christ that they practice their faith to God, their practice, their religion through the programs ng SM&I sa mga preachings po ng Kingdom.
Maraming salamat po. Tony, meron po kayong gusto idagdag?
Gusto ko lang idagdag po ng SM&I. Maraming pang programa nyo. Hindi lang yung dalawa, kasi ang dalawang pinag-initan ay yung mula sa masa, gikan sa masa, ng ang cordon ay si Pastor Kibuloy at saka si former President Duterte. At saka yung isang programa po ay laban kasama ng bayan. Ang course naman po doon ay si Dr. Lorraine Badoy at saka si Ka Eric Celis. Kami po ni Attorney Mark ay may sariling programa rin kami. So pag sinasabi mo pong SM&I, hindi lang mo yung dalawa, marami po yung programa sa loob ng SM&I. Kaya po ay kung pinag-iinitan yung dalawa, bakit isama yung buong network? Kasi marami pa eh. Hindi lang yun ang programa eh. So maraming salamat po.
Maraming salamat po.
Mr. Chair.
Sige po, Attorney
Hularbar po.
Hularbar, sir. Apo.
Mr. Chair, gusto ko lang itagdag tungkol sa restraint on the freedom of religion or even on the freedom of expression. Medyo may distinction ko kasi yung content-based restriction saka content-neutral restriction. Yung content-based restriction, pag pinipigilan mo yung mismong utterance, yung expression, yung content-neutral, pag medyo naglalagay ka ng restriction, then the manner of the exercise. Kunwari, pag sinabi natin bawal pag-usapan ang Quran, content-based restriction yan. Pero pag sinabi na pag-usapan nyo lang yung Quran sa lugar na ito o sa oras na ito, pwede not necessarily illegal yon or unconstitutional. So, while there is a violation of the right, may degrees po yan eh. And so, I'm just saying this as a cautionary measure na meron distinction po. Yung content-based and content-neutral.
Diba? Ganon din po sa Iglesia ni Cristo. At hindi po biro yung pangangapital. Pag tinignan po ninyo yung Net 25, daang milyon ang ginagastos. UNTV, Progressive Broadcasting, gumagastos din po sila. Ganun din po ang Swarasug ng kapital ang Kingdom of Jesus Christ ng 650 million, hindi po ako nagkakamali. Kapag ka o sinagka natin yan, ng basta-basta, eh, unang-una, sinagka natin yung evangelization ng reliyon. Especially now, in the modern Christian world, praise and worship are the best way of giving thanks to the Lord. CCF yan, Kingdom of Jesus Christ, MCGI, yan o eh, pag nanood kayo ng TV ngayon, talagang yung mga awit, yung mga psalms, yan ho ang pinakamabisang paraan ng pagkaganyak sa pagbabalik loob sa Panginoon. Sa iba't ibang kaparaanan, depende sa anong reliyon. Eh, kaya nga ho, pag sinyat of mo yan, of there, at yung tao, yun ang kanyang, dahil nga ho, doon na siya nakatutok eh, para sa kanyang pananampalataya. Eh, si, parang mong sinabi na rin, huwag na kang maniwala sa Diyos dahil of there kayo eh. Yun ho ang dating sa akin. Kaya medyo, nung po nangyari yan, ako'y talagang nabalisa itong pagkakasara. Hindi dahil sa ako'y kinuha consultant nila, kundi bilang isang mamamahayag na halos 50 taon na sa industriyang ito. Kaya sana po eh makapagpanday kayo ng mga panukala at kami naman po'y na mahandang tumulong sa pagbabalangkas na yan.
Salamat po. Ngayon naman po, babalansin lang po natin para marinig din po natin ang MTC. Uniulit ko po, hindi po tayo nag-aaway dito. Gusto lang po natin malinawan ng ating mga kababayan kung ano po yung naganap. Ang tanong lang po natin, ano, ito po ay pwede naman po yung hindi sagutin din dahil ito po ay nasa korte na din. Ano. Pero mainam din po siguro na in general, opo, halimbawa, wag po nating sabihin na SMNI lang. Sabihin po natin ibang network. Opo, sa ibang network po. Halimbawa, nasa mandato po ba ng komisyon ang pagsasagawa ng moto proprio na pagdinig?
Good morning. Good afternoon po, Mr. Chair. Opo, ayon po sa Public Service Act at saka po sa rules ng NTC, maaari po na mag-moto proprio initiate po ang commission kapag meron pong nalalaman ng commission na bagay na kailangan pong simulan ng investigasyon. Salamat po.
Apo, malinaw po yun. Tanong ko lang po, pagka ganito po bang may nagreklamo? Kasi lagi ko naman pong nakakasama din ng NTC sa ibang hearing, lalo na po pagkakasama natin yung MTRCB. Ano po? Tanong ko lang po, sino po ba dapat ang magrereklamo? Halimbawa, katulad po, sinabi nila mayroong hindi balanse na balita na inilabas yung isang host ng SMNI. Sino po ba dapat ang magreklamo sa NTC? MTRCB o private individual o kayo po mismo? NTC po mismo ang magreklamo?
Mr. Chair, ang tinutukoy po ba natin iyong content-based po na reklamo po?
Opo. Halimbawa lang po, sa ibang network nangyari yung
opo.
Ganito po. Ano?
Opo.
Sino po ang tamang magrereklamo, MTRCB, private citizen, o NTC mismo?
Sir, we, as regards content po kasi, dahil self-regulation po ang broadcast industry, so pag may dumadating po na mga complaint, or any ano na parang eto medyo false misinformation, or masyado namang hard-hitting yung mga broadcasters, nire-refer po namin yun, sir, sa KBP, sir. Meron po silang standards committee po that would standards authority that would reprimand or impose sanctions po doon sa nasabing broadcaster po.
Sir, may gusto po kayong sabihin sa ito?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Kino-confirm ko po yun. Kasi may Supreme Court ruling na hindi jurisdiction ng NTC ang content-based matters. Technical lang. Sa TV naman po, MTRCB po. Radio at yung self-regulations both radio and television. But complaints regarding content on TV can be referred to the MTRCB.
Paano po ang dynamics po nun? Halimbawa, pagka-radio po, KBB.
Radio at television
po. Radio at TV, opo.
KBB po.
Opo. Dito po sa, tanong ko lang po sa SMNI naman po, sa inyo po, sino po ba ang nagreklamo laban po sa...
Halimbawa po, Mr. Chairman, meron hong manunood o nakikinig sa aming impilan at sa tingin niya ay may kalabisan doon sa paghahayag. Pwede po siya mismong magreklamo sa amin dahil meron po tayong editorial board. Sila po ang magsisiyasat at magpapataw ng karampatang parusa kung kinakailangan. Kung yan ay hindi lang po sa SMNI, ha, kahit sa mga non-member ng KBP. Example po, halimbawa, ang GMA, hindi po miyembro ng KBP. And I think KBP can attest to that. Pagka humihingi kami noon, nung nandun ba ako, pagka nagkakamali at may reklamo, depende ho yan, pwedeng pagpapaliwanagan muna, no, he will be asked to explain why no sanction can be imposed against him or her. Pagkatapos kung mabigat po, depende ho yan sa bigat, mula 5 araw, 15 araw, 1 buwang suspensyon. Lamang ay para ay maproteksyonan yung image ng announcer, sinasabi namin, kunyari, o si Dipunto Mike Enriquez ay nakabakasyon ho. O si Mel Chang po nakabakasyon. Pero in reality, katulad nun sa ABS, pagka ho may order yung Standards Authority na suspension kunyari kay Corina Sanchez, ina-announce ho namin na on annual vacation po si Corina. O si Noli de Castro. Ganun po ang pangyayari. At isang po sa SMNI, ginagawa po namin, katunayan, may mga empleyado kami na nabibigyan ng sanksyon at saka mga nagtatrabaho sa SMNI. Kasi hindi naman po namin kinakailangan i-announce pa. Which is, kasi ngayon ho, medyo maano tayo dun sa mga human rights. Kasi nung panahon ho namin, nung in the old days of the industry, alam ito ni attorney, bago ka makapasok sa industriya, dadaan ka sa butas ng karayom. Pagka nakapasok ka naman, ayun, may tatanong yan. Ako, naging news director ako ng ABS. Malupit ho ako. Pagka umabuso, katulad noon, may isang reporter, hindi ko na babanggitin ang pangalan. Kami nasa Tagaytay, sinabi niya si Presidente Corin na declare ang martial law. Di talaga ho, kami biktima ng martial law. Napalipad kami pabalik ng Maynila. Yung pala, si Presidente Cory ay nag-declare ng state of emergency. Malayo-malayo ho. Yun ho, pinagbakasyon namin ng mahaba-haba yung reporter namin sa Malacanang. Kasi hindi dapat pinapalagpas. At kami po ay talagang kung ikaw ay nasunod bilang isang matapat na mamamayag, hindi ho kailangan ng mga suspensyon galing sa ibang lugar. Mismo, katulad ho ni, ito, babanggitin ko ng pangalan at pwede niyong tanungin. Si Gani Oro, isang magaling na broadcaster, kumukover ho ng demolition dyan sa Barangay Holy Spirit, gabi. Nagre-report siya, ang ganda ng report. Tigmak ng dugo, kumpirmado, may isang batang namatay. Habang naglalakad ho siya, nakita na naman niya may isang madugo. May batang hindi na sumisingap. Diniklara niyang patay. Suspendido siya. 15 days without pay. Kasi mabigat ho yan eh. Huwag na tayong lumayo. Nasuspendi si Tina Monzon Palma sa Channel 7. Nung pinatay niya yung biktima ni T. Hanky. Yung pala, nasa ICU pa ng Makati Med. Kaya siya nasuspindi rin. Kahit yung news director na siya noon ng GMA. Ganyan ho ang industriya. Dahil responsable ang mga practitioners. Hindi ho kami mga pipitsugi na hindi nakapag-aral o anong tawag dito. At saka we value yung training namin kasi noon. Pag ikaw nag-ondir, dapat gospel truth ang sinasabi mo. At yan din po ang panuntunan namin sa SMNI. Kaya ako nung sinabing, pwede ho bang magtanong, totoo ba na merong 1.8? Ang problema lang ho kasi noon, hindi kami pinayagan na ipalabas yung actual na video nung banggitin ni Eric Celis yung pagtatanong. Kasi kung pinayagan lang ho, malinaw eh. Oh, tinatanong lang, Mr. Speaker, totoo ba na 1.8 billion na inyong travel allowance? O ang nagastos ninyo? Kadali-dali naman sana, ang daming may public information ng Congress, di ba? Senado. Ano, ano? Ay, hindi totoo yan. 39 lang ang nagastos namin. Hindi tapos na sa ano. Hindi mo namin maintindihan ba't pinalaki hanggang mauwi sa suspension ng napagal, naiinalmusal kami. Ng NTC.
Salamat po, KJ. Meron lang po akong tanong na uli sa KBP. Ito po, ano po ba ang naging, kanina po nabanggit nyo na to, gusto ko lang pong palawakin ninyo. Ano po ang naging epekto sa KBP nung lumabas po yung indefinite suspension? Ito po ba ay nagbigay ng takot sa ating broadcasters?
Salamat po, Mr. Chair, sa tanong. Actually, the whole proceedings sa Congress at saka sa NTC, medyo nabahala po ang industriya. Parang may sword of Damocles sa ibabaw ng ulo. At sa parlance ng media, nagkaroon ng chilling effect. Importante na maingat ang mga mamahayag. Pero iba yung pag-iingat dahil takot ka. Okay, iba yun. At may epekto po sa mga paggalaw ng mga network dahil ayaw nilang masampulan din, kumbaga, ng either Congress,
importance ng press freedom and everything. But of course po, sa NTC naman ngayon ay yung aming pong mga pag-determine nung pending case po sa amin, eh may basihan naman din po kami. And it's not about ano po namin in this case, Your Honor, it's not about attacking the press freedom. It's actually on the compliance of the network to the terms and conditions na nakapapaloob po sa mga authorities at CPCN na binibigay po namin. Of course po, ang sinasabi nga natin na ang broadcast franchise, it's a privilege. And may mga obligasyon po ang mga broadcast station based na rin sa conditions na imposed sa franchises nila at sa conditions na imposed na rin po sa mga authorities that we provided na naka-anchor din po doon sa franchise na nanggagaling po sa Kongreso. Siguro po merong mang pagkakaiba ng opinion regarding po sa pangyayaring ito, pero hindi naman po kami gumagalaw nang wala pong basihan ang aming pong mga aksyon. Narinig ko lang po ang ano ngayon po ni Attorney Reggie Horalbar ng KBP. Of course po, nakakalungkot din po na may ganong klaseng epekto po sa industriya, but we want to assure po the industry that we are fair in our dealings and that may basis po ang aming mga aksyon. Pero yun nga po, since it's already pending with us and pending din po sa court, siguro po it's best for me not to say more. Baka ma-prejudge lang po ang outcome ng case. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Salamat po. Sa totoo lang po, nagpapasalamat po kami at nakilahok po kayo. Kahit ito ay, alam nyo na, nasa korte na. Napakalaking bagay po na nandito din kayo. Sa SMNA po, paano po kaya ang pagtanggap po ninyo? Kasi kanina, malinaw po na sinasabi po ng ating mga abogado, yung due process.
Yes po.
Opo, hinihingi nyo yung due process. Ang sinasabi naman po ng ating NTC, binigay naman po sa inyo yung due process. Binigay po ba?
Absolutely po. Hindi po nabigay yung due process po. Bakit? Ang basis po nila, kasi sabi po ni the good commissioner na may basihan daw po, ang basis po nila is the determination of the House of Representatives. Parang pinalabas po nila po that the NTC pwedeng diktahan pala ng House of Representatives. Kasi based on their resolution po, ang kanilang or order, the suspension is based on the determination of the House of Representatives. Wala pong, hindi po tayo binigyan ng pagkakataon na magpaliwanag na in fact, I believe that NTC is a quasi-judicial body. Hindi po siya under ng House of Representatives na basta-basta na lang diktahan ng mga congressman. Kasi very clear po, nakalagay po sa order nila, as determined by the House of Representatives per resolution number 129. And second, Mr. Chair, nakalagay din po doon sa rules ng NTC to protect the interests and welfare of the public. But walang nakalagay, bakit to protect the interests and welfare of the public, kailangan bigyan ng suspension, indefinite suspension, na hindi natin alam kung ilang araw, 10 years ba kami maghintay, 20 years ba kami maghintay, or until matapos yung prangkisa ng Suarsug Media Corporation. Ang nagbigay po ng prangkisa po is the House of Senate and the House of Representatives. Congress po, may batas po na nagbigay dyan. So, ibig sabihin, mawala ang prangkisa through amendment of a law, not just a mere order of a quasi-judicial body na hindi nga tayo binigyan ng pagkakataon, walang hearing, walang notice, in fact, documented po as determined by the House of Representatives. Ibig sabihin po, inaamin po ng NTC na panikta sila ng congressman or ng House of Representatives. Yan ang po ang masabi ko po.
Linawin ko po, yung pong indefinite suspension ninyo galing sa investigasyon ng House?
Yes po. Based, ito po yung order ng NTC, nakalagay po, as determined by the Committee of the House of Representatives. So, ibig sabihin po, yung kanilang resolution, nagbase lang po sila sa legislative investigation. So, violation po yan ng separation of power kasi the Congress is under the legislative body and NTC is under the Executive Department. So, ibig sabihin po, sinurrender po nila ang quasi-judicial power or function ng NTC and nagpadikta po sila through a document. Hindi po ako nagsasabi po nito. This is a document issued by NTC na nakalagay po doon as determined by the House of Representatives. This document is dated December 19, 2023, and also the order issued by the NTC dated January 18, 2024 and March 18, 2024. So ibig sabihin po, hindi lang isang dokumento na inaamin po ng NTC na nagpadikta sila o nagsinurrender po nila ang quasi-judicial power nila ng House of Representatives. We are in a presidential system po. Kasi presidential system, iba ang executive department, iba ang legislative department. Separate po sila po. But in this case, walang hearing, walang notice, walang investigation. Sabi nila, motu proprio. Motu proprio, but based on the determination of the House of Representatives. Where in fact, nakita nyo man po, in the legislative committee sa House of Representatives, hindi po tayo binigyan ng pagkakataon na magpaliwanag. In fact, dalawa po sa mga angkor ng Sorasug, nakulong ng 7 days dahil lang sa na-contempt daw. And in fact, kung magsalita po tayo, one sentence, two sentence, may mga pananakot na po na pa-contempt po kami ni Congressman, ni Attorney Rolex Sublico. So, and documented po yan, public knowledge po yan, na dalawa sa aming mga anchors po ang nakulong. Nakulong for 7 days, isa sa anchor po namin, no less than the former President Duterte, dinimanda sa Quezon City Prosecutor's Office. So, yun po ang nangyari na I'm sure hindi po matanggihan ng NTC kasi properly documented po yan. And inamin po nila ng basis po nila for the suspension or the indefinite suspension is the resolution of the House of Representatives.
Salamat po. Hindi ko na po masyadong dadapuan pa kung ano po yung kaso pa kasi nasa court na po kayo. Eh, no?
Per record po, wala pong kaso po. Actually po, yung sa magpa-file pa sana kami ng kaso. Kung may nag-file ng kaso po, it's not the NTC, it's not the Sorasug Media Corporation, mga individual person like the person of Attorney Roque
and mga anchors,
they're filing in their personal capacity.
Hindi po ang network.
So, ang network po, hindi po kami na nagpa-file pa. But we are planning to file. We are admitting that we are planning to file an
nung ako'y maimbita, sabi ko, ba ito'y magandang pagkakataon para malaman ng Kongreso kung anong nangyayari sa industriya at kinakailangang ayusin. Halimbawa, noong nagtanong si Kinagawan Kimbo tungkol sa bayaran ng mga yuswelduhan po ng anchors, tama-tama dahil sa committee nyo, Public Information and Mass Media, alam nyo yun ang problema sa industriya. Napakarami ho ng mga broadcaster referring to network, ano ho, ang on the air pero wala hong economic viability. Ibig sabihin, hindi kaya magpasweldo ng tama sa mga empleyado. Pangalawa, sa mga malalaking network, ang dami yung violation. Kasi sa batas po, sa unang araw pa lang ng panunungkulan mo sa alinmang network, kinakailangan ikaw ay nabibigyan na ng social amelioration tulad ng SSS, Pag-ibig, PhilHealth. Maniwala kayo sa hindi. Matagal na tayong pareho sa industriya, Mr. Chairman. Mahigit po sa kalahati ang walang SSS. Walang PhilHealth. Walang pag-ibig. Pagmamahal, meron po marami yan sa industriya natin. Pero yung pag-ibig fan, wala ho sa housing. Yun nga ho sana gusto kong ipaliwanag sa kanila kasi ang dami yung kalakaran na sa tingin natin ay dapat lagyan ng karampatang aksyon. Either sa pagsusog sa mga umiiral na batas o tuluyang pagbalangkas ng bagong batas. Dahil kumikita po sila ng bilyones. Pero yung kakarampot na social amelioration ng kanilang mga magagawa, hindi una ay pagkakaloob. So, sipin nyo ha, sa industriya po ng media, para sa kabatiran ng publikong nanonood o nakikinig, meron nung sumusweldo dyan ng tuwing 5 at 20. May sumusweldo ng tuwing 10 at 25. May sumusweldo ng 15 at saka katapusan. Meron sumusweldo pagkatapos ng taping. Marami yung klase. Kaya, nung pinagpapalaya, bakit iba-iba yung patakaran nyo sa anchors at saka sa regular employees? Talaga ho magkaiba. Oh. Kasi, yun ho mga anchors, talent fee ho yan, per contract. Oh, pag nag-violate ka ng contract, pwede pang alisin yan. So, kaya nga ho noon, nung sa ABS pa ako, dalawang tambiolo pag Christmas party. Isa doon sa mga may talent at doon sa mga walang utak. Ako kasi, hinihiwalay ho nila yung raffle ticket ng mga talent employees at saka doon sa regular employees. Kaya pag magdodraw ako noon, ako nag-MC. O ito, para mananalo yung mga walang utak pero may talent. Dinadaan na lang sa biro. Pero hindi ho maganda. Kaya tama-tama itong consultative meeting na ito para mapag-aralan ninyong lupon kung ano ang nararapat na aksyon. Para binabahagi po namin ito bilang input sa inyo, Mr. Chairman.
Salamat po. Meron lang po akong ito pong tanong na ito. Yung po bang, halimbawa po, meron isang, tanong ko po ito sa DOJ. DOJ boss. Opo, DOJ. Halimbawa po, di ba meron lagi sa mga programa, nandyan yung sinasabi, yung the views and opinions expressed by the host do not necessarily state or reflect those of the company and its management. So, paano po yun? Halimbawa, kinasuhan yung host. Yun po ba automatic sabit yung programa? Ganun po ba yun? Sa DOJ, ganun po ba yun? Pagka kinasuhan mo yung host, dama yung programa. Ganun po ba yun? O yung host lang ang sasabit? Kasi dito po, ito yata pagkatapos po ito nung programa, di ba po, lumalabas po ito? The views.
Before and after po.
Yun, before and after. Paano po yun?
Sa tingin ko, Mr. Chair, depende sa kaso. Anong particular na kaso ba?
Halimbawa po, katulad po nung nangyari po sa SMNI, yung isang host may tanong daw po. Yun po ang sabi ng SMNI, tinanong lang daw po ni ka-Eric. Halimbawa lang po ito, halimbawa lang. Sinabi niya na totoo bang ganitong presyo? Wala naman, hindi naman daw po ito, kumbaga exclamation point, kumbaga question mark. Pero ang dumating, ang nangyari, parang naging ito ay exclamation point. So parang ang, halimbawa, kinasuhan si ka-Eric, pati ba yung show niya, damay? Ganun po ba yun? O si ka-Eric lang, dahil nagkamali daw siya, mali ang kanyang sinabi. Pag ganun po ba, ano ba yun? Libelous po ba yun, attorney? Pag ganun ba, libelous? Allegedly, di ba? Ganun po, allegedly yun ang sinabi niya, na may 1.8 billion.
Depende yan, Mr. Chair, no? Yung, kasi yung...
Pwede po, halimbawa, talagang pwedeng madama yung programa. Halimbawa po, kinasuhan yung host, dinamay yung programa. Pagka dinamay po ba yung programa, pati yung istasyon, Halimbawa po, pinarusahan yung host at pati yung programa. O sige, mali yung programa na yan. Cancelahin yan. Yung po bang network, kakansilahin din.
Mr. Chair, initially, ano, ang tingin ko dyan, kung pagbabasihan natin yung yung laging pinapakita na the views of the course that not, does not necessarily personal ko nung anchor or broadcast.
Tama yung publisher. Sa, ewan ko kung anong ginawa ng KPPPMC noon na siya naging alituntunin, yung mga waiver na ganyan. I mean, si Attorney Reggie siguro can educate us. Dahil nung unang panahon, wala naman nung ganun eh. Kasi nga wala naman masyadong black timer nung araw, walang co-production. Talagang pag-announcer ka ng Manila Broadcasting, announcer ka talaga. Pag-announcer ka ng ABS, kasi nag-iba eh, tumatako, nag-evolve yung industriya. Hanggang ngayon, marinig mo, bago mapir si Boy Abunda, meron din ganyan eh. So, hindi lang sa political programs. Ewan ko kung... Pero noon, depende ko sa abogado eh. Kasi nung ako yung news director, yung mga anchors namin sa DCMM at saka sa channel 2, pag nadidemanda ng libel, kami sinasama sa kaso yung news director, yung presidente ng kumpanya, ganon.
Mr. Chair.
Salamat po, sir. Apo.
May give some...
Apo. Please, apo.
Mr. Chair, nabanggit nga ni Kasamang Jay, magkaiba yung print at saka broadcast. Yung print kasi may opportunity to edit out and correct before it is published. Ang broadcast po, immediate, live. At saka may basehan po sa provision ng prangkisa. Yung lumang prangkisa, mga 60s, nakalagay, the grantee shall not require any previous censorship of any speech, play, act, or scene on any matter to be broadcast. Ibig sabihin, hindi mo pwedeng sabihin kay Jay na, Jay, wag mong pag-usapan to. Bawal. May freedom po siya. Ganun ka-importante yung freedom of expression. The same provision is found in the current franchises. Uniform po. It states, self-regulation by an undertaking of the grantee. The grantee shall not require any previous sponsorship of any speech, play, act, or scene, or other matter to be broadcast from its station, provided that the grantee during any broadcast shall cut off from the air speech, play, etc. that might incite to rebellion, etc. Ibig sabihin mo, post-edit, quote-unquote. Pag nagsasalita na si Jay at bumabanat na siya out of bounds, pwede kong sabihin, Jay, tama na. Pero bago pa niya masabi, hindi ko siya pwedeng sabihin na hindi mo pwedeng sabihin. Ganun po kahalaga ang freedom of expression. So, yung waiver po na sinasabi, may basehan. Kasi kung hindi kita mapigilan bago mo sabihin, kailan wala akong liability. Extension lang yun ng provision ng practice. Salamat po.
Salamat po, Attorney Jular Bal. Napakalinaw po pag kayo po ay nagpapaliwanag. Salamat po sa inyong paliwanag. So, tanungin ko lang po yung SMNI. Sa palagay po ninyo, meron po ba talagang nalabag sa code of conduct ng SMNI ang inyong host?
Alam nyo, nagsasagawa ko kaming ng investigasyon noon. Hindi pa kami tapos. Dahil ongoing po sa house. umamin po si, ano, siguro, hindi namin alam kung siya'y napilitang umamin nang nagkamali siya, nag-sorry siya sa Committee on Legislative Franchise. Habang ginagawa namin yung internal investigation. So, kung inamin niya at siya po'y nag-sorry na nagkamali siya, eh sabi namin, ano pang silbi nitong investigation natin? Kasi umamin siya. Hindi namin alam kung anong nag-trigger sa kanya. So, pursuant to our guidelines, we have to impose disciplinary action on him. That's why he was suspended from going on the air for ilang araw yon? Ha? 10 days. 10 days. Kasi kami nga ho, sabi nga namin, ma-stricto sa ano eh, sa broadcast eh. Yung yumaong ni Locampo, hindi lang nakasagot sa radyo sa akin, sinuspindi ko ng 5 araw eh.
Pero sa inyo po, KJ, sa inyo pong opinion, ilabas po natin yung paghingi niya ng dispensa. Malamang po, talagang mahilig lang siyang humingi ng dispensa. Kayo po, mismo ang SMNI, sa inyo pong...
Kami ho, kung nagtuloy sana yung investigasyon at na-review namin yung TOA, tape on air ang tawag natin dyan, noong unang panahon, makikita namin doon yung bigat sana nung pagkaka... Kaya nga ho sinasabi ko eh, kumisan ito yung problema natin sa Pilipinas. That because we come from different regional tongue, yung dila natin. Eh kumisan, yung sinasabi ng isa, pagka hindi siya bihasa sa pananagalog, nagiging iba ang dating. No? Diba, nag-ibog, magkuhan niya, ay, Bisaya yon. Pag narinig na Tagalog yon, sabi mo, bastos naman nun. Pati yung libog niya, pinag-usapan nun, dear. Pero actually, nalilito ang ibig sabihin nun. So, in the case of Ka-Eric, Ilunggo eh. So, sa
maganda po, kung makita po natin.
Para at least, yun nga ako, kaya ako, kasi galing din ako ng probinsya, importante yung ano eh, yung tono eh. Kaya kahit na si Presidente, di ba? Presidente Duterte, kumisa na hirap siya mag direct translation ng ano ng Tagalog, from Bisaya to Tagalog. Kaya siguro yan ang kailangan, medyo lawakan natin yung pangunawa sa ating mga kababayan. Kasi kaya nga hanggang ngayon mahaba po yung debate kung alin ang national language natin, kung Tagalog ba o Bisaya o Ilocano eh, kasi magkakaiba ho talaga eh.
Mr. Chair, explain ko sana po in legal view po yung sinasabi po ni Ka-Eric. Kasi if you check po the definition of libel, nakalagay po doon that statement of a discreditable act or condition. So when you say statement po, hindi tanong. Kasi kung batas po yung pag-uusapan natin, statement, ibig sabihin, kailangan may statement si Ka-Eric. So is a question a statement? Oh, definitely, hindi po siya statement. That's why kung i-demanda po si Ka-Eric ng libel, madidismiss po yan kasi there was no statement of discreditable act or condition. But granting it was a statement, still covered po siya ng privileged communication. Because if you're a public officer, you should not be on your skin. You are subject to public criticism, public ridicule, as part of the principle ng ating saligang batas that public office is public trust. Yun po yung stand po namin sa legal team po ng SMNI.
Salamat po. Tanungin ko lang po yung ating mga, marami namang abogado po dito, pero unahin ko na po si Attorney Abad. Attorney, yung po bang indefinite, yung salitang indefinite, yung po ba constitutional yun? Sususpindihin ka ng indefinite, hindi mo alam. Kumbaga, ikaw ay palutang-lutang lang. Ito po ba eh, okay po ba yan? Meron po ba talagang indefinite?
I think
Mr. Chair, hindi natin masasabi na unconstitutional siya. Pero yung lack of definite timeline pagdating sa mga suspensions and other forms of punishment might be a violation of due process. But it will be based on the case. So kailangan pag-aralan yung case and whether the application of the word indefinite for a suspension is actually a denial of due process. It's given, dapat lahat ng proseso, both procedural and substantial due process nandun bago ilatag yung ano yung rule on whether it's going to be definite or indefinite.
May gusto po kayong sa NTC? Ano po ba kayong...
Pwede ba magdagdag po sa...
Meron po kayong gustong sabihin patungkol po dun sa indefinite?
Mr. Chair, siguro po, maliit na clarification.
Ulitin ko po, hindi po tayo hearing, ha? So, free, ano lang po tayo, ha? Pwede po tayong mag-usap. Hindi po ito hearing. Consultation.
To clarify lang po, yung inisyo po ng commission po dun sa order ay cease and desist, hindi naman po indefinite suspension. It's just incident to yung para po magsimula na po yung proceedings during the time para po makapag-start na po yung investigation and the administrative case that is ongoing before the commission.
Okay, yun po. Pwede po kayo attorney po.
Kasi po, may jurisprudence po sa Pilipinas po na any order of any government agencies that affect freedom of press and freedom of expression are presumed unconstitutional. So, iba yan sa ibang mga orders ng ating government agencies na may nakalagay, there is a presumption of regularity. Except pag freedom of press and expression ng pag-uusapan, ang presumption ng government agencies are unconstitutional kung it affects freedom of press and freedom of expression. In the case of Chavez versus NTC, so, ang basis po natin, that's why we believe na lahat po ng order ng NTC are presumed unconstitutional kasi it affects freedom of press and freedom of expression. Hindi nila pwedeng sabihin that it is presumed regular kasi is there a conflict between the presumption of regularity and the presumption of unconstitutionality when it affects freedom of press and freedom of expression, the presumption of unconstitutionality will prevail.
Tony Suplico.
Thank you, Chairman. Chairman, balikan ko lang itong ano, ha? Yung first order, yung 30-day suspension order. Ito ay dated December 19, 2023. Ang dispositive portion po, pinakadulo yun, sasabi, in view thereof, having been determined by the House of Representatives in Resolution Number 189. So, wala ko silang ginawa. Pinasihan lamang nila yung Resolution 189 ng House of Representatives. Tapusin ko po, ha. That respondent Suarasog has violated several provisions of its franchise. So yung determination galing doon. Yung third paragraph below ito, ito ang sinasabi. Furthermore, taking cognizance of the House of Representatives declaration that respondent Suarasog has violated several provisions of its legislative franchise and giving due deference to such determination, of the House of Representatives and its authority over all matters directly and principally relating to the grant, amendment, extension, or revocation of franchises, the Commission subscribe and verify. I-resolution po yan ng House eh. Paano maging complaint yan? Eka nga, anong law school ang tinuturo na ang resolution? Complaint ba yun? Subscribe and sworn to. So ito po, nung pre-hearing conference, walang complaint na. wala rin complaint. Eh bakit umusad ito na dumating sa punto na ang 58 stations nitong Suwarasog sinara? So parang one for the books po ito eh. Ngayon lang nangyari ito eh. Ako yung pipichilin ko pang sarili ko para magising ako eh. Paniwalaan ko na nangyari ito eh.
Di po, Ajay.
Pwede po mag-rejoinder. Kami po, bagamat ganyan na nga ang pangyayari, bilang pagkilala sa quasi-judicial body na National Telecommunications Commission, eh sumunod po kami sa alituntunin nila. Nagpatawag ng pre-trial, pinanggit namin lahat ang aming posisyon, at sinabi namin dahil sa tingin namin ay hindi nasunod yung kanilang sariling mga panuntunan, eh kahapon po ay nag-submit kami ng aming paninindigan at prayer o motion to dismiss the case, kung ano man yung kaso. Kasi hindi ho namin alam kung ano yung kaso dahil wala ho kami, wala naman ho talagang on record, on file na kaso. At saka, kung pwede po, minamarapat namin at pinagdarasal namin na sana'y sa Bisaya pa malamdagan unta sa Espiritu Santo ang commissioner nga iyang i-lift na ang suspension order. Yun lang naman po eh. Dahil tayo'y mga Kristiyano, tayo'y mga believer ng Panginoon, ala kung ano man ang tawag natin, na para mamuhay tayo ng tahimik, eh, magkaunawaan tayo at sana po eh, hindi man marapat, eh kami humingi na kung sakali po at nabasa na nila at mababasa nila dahil kahapon lang namin sinumit eh sana ay sa lalong madaling panahon ay bigyan ng karapatan yung lahat ng mga nakasubaybay no sa SMNI na ito'y muling ma especially doon po sa mga believers ng JKOJC na nangapital para sa kanilang reliyon eh mapanood muli no. Kasi sa aming pong palagay at sa aming paniniwala, wala ho kaming nasuway, nalabag. Whether consciously or not, na mga panuntunan ng ating republika, whether constitution, existing laws, or even rules and regulation of the National Telecommunications. Yun lamang po naman ang aming maliit na panambitan, Mr. Chairman. Na sana eh maging mabilis kasi nga diba, sabi natin pagka justice delays, justice denied. Ayaw naman po naming maniwala na ang ating mga nanunungkulan sa NTC ay bereft of those principles. Maraming salamat po.
Maraming salamat po. Comsec, handa na yung video para makita natin. Ayun, short lang.
Paiksi lang yan.
Apo. So habang inaantay po natin yung video, ano lang ko po sa Commission on Human Rights. Sir, ma'am, attorney, yung indefinite, ano po ba sa palagay niyo? Yung po ba, nakakapaglabag po ba ng karapatan yon, yung indefinite? Kasi nung ako po'y nabilibid, kapag mo yung 10 taon, pwede ka nang mabigyan ng numero. So wala talagang indefinite. Sa kayo po ba? Ano po ba ang ano nyo sa... Yung po ba eh hindi nalalabag ang karapatan natin sa indefinite na parusa?
Sa pagkakaalam namin, dapat lahat ng sinasanction in accordance with the law, rules and regulation of a particular agency, sir. Kung meron silang nakalagay sa rules and regulation na itong violation na to galing sa isang malinaw na complaint ay magbibigay ng karampatang parusa na nakalagay ay indefinite suspension, Pwede. Pero kung walang ganon, arbitrary naman po, nabigyan sila ng indefinite.
Pero, Miss Ina, before your question, ma'am.
Sinasabi niyo po, kung nasa rules ng NTC yung indefinite, pwede yun.
Kung yun po sana, kung meron po sana sa rules, duly published, and inform po ang lahat ng parties.
Opo. Meron po bang ganun sa NTC?
Kung tungkol po ito sa pag-issue ng cease and desist order po, nasa rules po ng NTC po.
Salamat po. Opo. Ibalik ko po sa inyo. Okay lang po ba yun na nagkakaroon tayo ng ganung klaseng parusa, indefinite? Kasi naalala ko po yun kahit sa kulungan nung araw. Kapag kay ikaw ibabartulina, bawal din yung walang araw na ibabartulina ka. Ano po ito? Hindi po ito hearing ha? Ano lang po ito? Consultation lang. Hindi po tayo nagtatalo. Wala po itong ganun. Ano lang po ito? Para lang po sa kaalaman natin. Opo.
Opo. Bagamat hindi ko kami partido do sa kaso o sa PIN ng tungkol sa SMNI, medyo may nagkakaroon lang ho ng kalituhan kami din sapagkat pag-intindi nung pinag-uusapan sapagkat sa kabilang bandaw, ang SMNI, ang binabanggit ho ay indefinite suspension. Sa kabilang banda naman, ang NTC, ang binabanggit nila ay cease and desist order. So magkaiba ho yung ating pinag-uusapan. Ang sa amin po, katulad ho ng nabanggit ni Attorney Gemma, kung ang pag-impose ng indefinite suspension ay nasa batas o regulasyon na duly published and informed ang publiko, po pwede hong gawin yun. Kung wala, hindi ho po pwedeng mag-impose ka ng suspension nang wala hong kawakulang period. Paglabag ho yun sa karapatan ng kung sino man na apektado nito. Ngayon pong cease and desist order, hindi ho namin alam kung ano po yung pinanggagalingan kasi pagkat hindi ho, magkaiba po yung sinasabi nila.
So, malinaw po, yung salitang indefinite sa inyo po, palagay, wala pong NTC, wala pong SMNI. Pag sinabi lang na indefinite suspension, indefinite sentence, ito po bang salitang ito ay katanggap-tanggap para sa isang karapatan ng tao?
Kung wala hong pinagbabasihang regulasyon yan or batas, hindi ho katanggap-tanggap yun.
Okay, yun po. Maraming salamat po. Panoorin po natin itong video para malinaw po tayo.
May na-break-in information tayo. In a form of question, kay Speaker Martin Romualdez, 1.8 billion ang travel cost niya.
Nako.
1.8 billion pesos.
For how long?
For almost one year lang.
For the entire Congress?
Sa kanya lang.
Sa kanya lang? Office?
Kaya nagtatanong itong ating source from Congress.
Is it true?
1.8 billion. Sabi niya, pakitanong kay Eric at paki-explain din. Gosh. At pakitanong kay Secretary Belica. Miss Ina, ito ay break-in information coming from Congress mismong source.
No, because the 1.1 billion of the DNNR, that's the entire department.
Yeah.
But you're saying now, Eric, that 1.8 billion is just the office of the speaker for travel?
Which is a question posed to us by the source from Congress.
Yeah, the speaker should explain, no?
Yes.
He should confirm or deny and then give an explanation.
Give an explanation kung totoo ito. Kasi sabi niya, baka humigit pa ka, Eric, kung i-factor in Secretary Belica, ang current baka umabot ng 2 billion. Ang gastos sa travel ni Speaker Martin Romualdez at ng kanyang mga entourage.
Okay. So, dito po pala, sinasabi niya, may tanong, may source, ano? Nagtatanong. Okay. Hindi na po ako magdadagdag dahil ayoko pong masabit dyan sa sub-judicium na yan. Meron din lang po ako papapanood na isang video din. Ito po, kasi kanina nabanggit yung red tagging. Kailangan lang po akong mag-react kasi sa pelikula ko po galing yung sinasabi na information na ibinigay ni Joma. Ito po yung pelikulang Memoirs of a Teenage Rebel. Ito po yung pelikulang yon. Ito po yung binabanggit ni KJ.
It is true that a minority class, especially only the party which represents it, cannot win direct the Philippine Revolution all by itself. Anyway, even while there are the forces of armed revolution, there are the legal democratic forces in the Philippines. The biggest of these is Bagong Alyansang Makabayan, or Bayan in short. It has a membership of more than 2 million members in more than 1,000 member organizations. Its biggest component organizations are Kilusang Mayo Uno, which is the labor center, the Pambansang Kilusang Magpubukid, which is the, or the Kilusang Magpubukid ng Pilipinas, or KMP, Gabriela, the Women Alliance, League of Filipino Students, Alliance of Concerned Teachers.
Kailangan ko lang pong ilabas yun kasi pelikula ko po yun. Opo, yun po ang... Opo. Kaya nailabas ko lang po para maano po. Ngayon, hindi ko na po masyadong pahabain kung may... Meron lang po kayong mga gusto pang huling gusto pang sa isang bit nasa
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Maraming salamat po, Attorney Binuya Jr. Ma'am Paruhinog, Attorney.
Sa, with due deference to our chair, sa CHR, wala na po kaming idadagdag. Pero kung meron po kayong gustong maklarify pa, willing naman po sumagot ang komisyon.
Maraming salamat po. Sir, Honorable Richard.
Maraming salamat po, Chair, Mr. Chair. Sa panig po ng Commission on Human Rights, patuloy po na kaming makikipag-ugnayan sa inyong tanggapan. At kung inyo pong mamarapatin, kung hihilingin nyo po sa amin, we can submit our position paper para mas ma-discuss po namin ng mas malinaw at mas mahaba, mas komprehensibo yung mga issues na gusto po ninyong maliwanagan. Maraming salamat po.
Maraming salamat po. At kailangan po namin kayo dito sa committee nito. Sapagkat kailangan po natin bigyan ng protection lahat ng taong bayan, lalo na po siyempre ang media. Salamat po. Attorney Mark Tolentino.
By the way, Mr. Chairman, nagpapasalamat po tayo sa for giving us an opportunity na to explain our side. And sama sa sinasabi po ko po, that we are consistent sa sinasabi namin that wala pong nalabag not any provisions ng prangkisa ng SMNI. And yung defend po natin is not only about SMNI. It's beyond SMNI. It's about freedom of press, freedom of expression, and kasama na doon po ang religious freedom po. Thank you.
Maraming salamat po, Attorney. Congressman, opo.
Maraming salamat po, Senator Padilla. Iba yung atmosphere dito, iba yung atmosphere sa house. Dapat is very in sila, verified, subscribe, you complain. Alam niyo po, siyaman taon na ako sa house, ibang-ibang house noon. Iba-iba yung house ngayon. At ako po gusto kong magpapasalamat sa iyo na malaya po kami nagsasalita dito. Wala pa kami danger nilalagay sa kulungan. Mga kaibigan ko rin yung mga tao doon na, pero nag-iingat kami magsalita doon, baka ikulong kami. Kaibigan ko sila doon po. Kaya alam po, una po, no, responsibility to the public. Ito po, bantayan natin, no, sa Republic Act 11422, Section 4, nakalagay po dyan, for the dissemination of deliberately false information or willful misrepresentation, wala po nangyaring ganito eh. Kumingi na ng paumanhin eh. Si Ka Eric, hindi lang isa, dalawa o tatlong beses pa eh. Pangalawa po, Ito po, no? Say, lease, transfer, grant of use of rank or assignment of franchise, section 10. Eh, wala namang controlling interest na ilipat, eh. Pag sinasabi po natin controlling interest, ibig sabihin po, 50%+. Ito po, wala, eh. 46% lang ang nailipat, eh. Definitely, 46 is not 50% plus. Kasi manaro, pag kumuha ka ng 75 at 74, magkaiba po yun. Pag 75 ka, pasado ka. Pag 74 ka, bagsak ka. Ito po, dispersal of ownership. Mismo ho, yung franchise ng pagmamayari ng pamilya ni Speaker, nakalagay within 5 years. Ito wala eh. Kasalanan ba namin kung nakaligtaan, ilagay yung within 5 years? Wala ho eh. Ito po ho, ha, reporter requirements. Sa unang hearing pa lamang doon sa House Committee on Legislative Franchises, sinabi na namin tinanggap ng committee secretary ang annual report namin. Ngayon po, lumalabas, hindi doon namin natanggap. Pero po, ito ha, hindi maaring magkaroon ng grant po ng NTC ng 58 applications kung hindi po kami kung walang compliance certificate doon sa committee ng House, Committee on Legislative Franchises, at saka Committee on Public Services. Ginran po kami, so pinipresume namin na binigyan kami ng clearance. Okay. Finally po, fine. Ito pala po, ang violation ng reportorial requirements, 500 pesos lang pala per day ang penalty. Nandiyan po sa franchise. So, nabibigla ako bakit dumating kami dito eh. At finally po, no, yung hindi nagawa ng Kongreso, House of Representatives at Senate, ginawa po ng NTC. Binusalan po kami. Ulitin ko po ha, hindi po nagawa ng Kamara. Kasi po, Kongreso, bicameral eh. Dapat kasamang Senado. Sila po, nagawa nila, nabusalan kami. At for the first time po, ang isang network na may 58 stations ay sinara. Binusalan po ng NTC. Marami salamat po.
Salamat po, Congressman. KJ?
Sa ngalan po ng SMNI, ng Suarasug Corporation, Media Corporation, galak na galak ko kami sa pangyayaring ito sapagkat sabi nga ho nila eh, dito malaya naming naihahayag kung ano yung aming saloobin at yung mga iba pang karanasan na maaaring makatulong. Siguro isang ano lang ho, panawagan sa Committee on Public Information and Mass Media to take a look and probably revisit the Public Service Act, which, kung titingnan ho natin, maliban doon sa amendment na ilang portion lang, in 1936 pa ho, ang batas. Mas matandang lihamak kaysa sa ating lahat. Kahit na ho siguro sa mga abogado rito. Tingnan ho ninyo, ang dami na ho doon. Kasi nga ho, isang example doon, Madam Secretary, ano ho, ang nakalagay ho doon ang penalty pagka may mga paglabag. Halimbawa, may paglabag ang isang network. Sabi lang doon, mag-a-appoint yung Public Service Commission ng isang tao. At pag-aharapin, para lang pag-usapan kung magkano imumulta. Tingnan nyo, revisit nyo yung Public Service Act na yun. Kasi nung sinusugan ho ito 2023 na inaprubahan ng both houses, eh doon lang ho sa pagmamayari ng 100% eh. Wala ho yung ibang provision hindi tinignan. Na alam ko makakatulong din ito sa NTC sa kanilang pagbibigay ng karampatang aksyon sa mga posibleng mga violations in the future. Maraming salamat po muli sa ngala ng Suarasug Media Corporation, sa ngala ng Sunshine Media Network International at sa Board of Directors po namin na aking kinatawan ngayong araw na ito. Thank you very much. At kung meron nung ibang pagkakataon na magkapangita tayo at makapagtalamitan ng malaya, eh nakalaan po kami para humarap sa inyo.
Salamat po, KJ. Sir, Attorney Andres. Apo.
Maraming salamat po, Mr. Chair, sa pagdinig po na ito. At nagkaroon po kami ng pagkakataong marinig po ang mga bawat panig. Maraming salamat po.
Salamat po. Ma'am Commissioner?
Mr. Chair, in behalf of the Commission po, nagpapasalamat din po kami sa pag-imbita niyo sa amin dito. At naging collaborative po ang ano ang resulta po ng ating pag-meeting na ito at hindi adversarial, sir. Maraming salamat po. Well, NTC po is always here po to assist the committee sa mga bagay po na kakailanganin yung aming serbisyo. Salamat po.
Opo. Salamat po, Ma'am Commissioner. Opo. Ma'am, baka may gusto po kayong idagdag? Thank you po. Sir!
In behalf of the KPP, we would like to thank the Honorable Chairperson for this opportunity to air our opinions, side, and position on issues related to the freedom of expression, press, and freedom of religion. The KPP views the developments, particularly with reference to the action on the franchise of SMNI, with grave seriousness. Kasi ang implikasyon niyan sa buong broadcast industry. At sana sa resolution ng issues, mangibabaw yung respeto ng freedom of expression, press, and freedom of media, mass media. At saka, due process should always be observed. Ngayon po, nabanggit din yung Public Service Act. Idagdag ko na rin. We joined the request to review the Public Service Act for two reasons. One is the Public Service Act seems to be the basis for requiring a congressional franchise on broadcast because it was classified as a public utility. Second, yung dispersal of ownership. Kung public service ang broadcast media, hindi na mag-a-apply because dispersal of ownership applies to public utility. Yan, napakahalaga po yung review ng Public Service Act. Yun po, Mr. Chair. Sana maging instrumento tayo sa pag-observe ng freedoms that are guaranteed by the Constitution.
Maraming salamat po, Atty. Julagban. Maraming salamat po. Ma'am Lydia ng NPC.
Yes po, muli po nagpapasalamat kami sa committee ng Public Information and Mass Media sa pagkakataong binigay sa amin to share our views on press freedom and its consequences po. Hindi man po kami direktang may say sa kaso ng SMNI, still po, narito po rin po ang National Press Club para po itaguyod ang malayang pamamahayag. At just want to make it clear na yung membership po kasi ng National Press Club is natural person, so hindi po yung juridical person. Kaya po ang members po namin from SMNI, siguro po ilan lang din po yon. Kaya kahit po hindi sila yung involved, still po nandun kami sa likod para ipagtanggol din po sila. At sana nga po hindi po maging president ang kasong ito sa iba pang mga kasama namin sa pamamahayag. Maraming salamat po.
Attorney Abad?
Well, again, thank you, Mr. Chairman, for having me here. Although I'm not involved in this case, but I observe it carefully, and it raises some important issues about revisiting our basic freedoms and rights that we have in our Constitution. So I stand ready to help you. As always, no, sa mga dadating na legislation, reforms na gusto nyong gawin, even in reviewing the Constitution, I'm here to help you out, Mr. Chairman.
Meron po tayong assignment, yung Public Service Act. Yan po ang assignment natin, Attorney.
Pag-aaralan ko.
Opo, opo. Maraming salamat po uli sa binigay niyong panahon sa ating pong consultation meeting. Ako naman po, ang gusto ko lamang pong ihayag sa ating lahat ngayong oras na to. Meron po kasi tayong malinaw sa saligang batas, yung paghihiwalay ng Estado at ng religion. Sana maikapit po natin yon. Meron pong mga programa sa SMNI na may kinalaman po sa religion. Ako na po siguro ang isa sa mga nakikiusap sa mga ating mga namumuno na pagdating po sana sa usapin ng religion. huwag natin itong isama sa political issue. Isang bagay ito na karapatan ng ating mga mamamayan. Respetuhin natin kung ano man po yung issue ngayon dito. Huwag po nating kalimutan na meron tayong mga kababayan na nakasalalay ang kanilang pananampalataya sa mga programa po sa kanilang network. Yun lamang po, wala po ako ditong ano, inuulit ko po. Ito ang kailangan natin sa bayan natin, mag-usap-usap. Hindi po tayo dapat nagbabangayan, hindi nagsisigawan, hindi nagpapakulungan. Ang kailangan po dito, lahat tayo partners para ang ating pong bayan ay pumunta talaga sa progreso. Kaya muli po, maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Dito po sa ating komite, ang lahat po ay may boses. Maraming salamat po. Mabuhay po kayo. Maraming salamat.
Salamat, boss.
Subscribe to SMNI News Channel.